Hey, how you doing? It's Emilio here. This video, we're going to be talking about how to protect folders on your Mac, how to protect folders and how to protect files by locking files, but also looking at how to set up password protection and encryption on your Mac. Hey, this video is brought to you by Moonlock, where we do cybersecurity technology for humans. Before we do get into this video, please also remember to click on that subscription button, clicking on the bell so you don't miss out on any of our future video releases. All right, so there are two main ways that you can actually protect folders on your Mac. Now, the first is to lock a folder. And what you're doing here is you're essentially setting up a little tick on a folder to actually protect it from accidental deletion, to protect any additional files from being added and files from being removed. And this is built into macOS. Very, very easy to look at how to do this. We'll show you how to do that in a second. The other thing that you can do is actually look at how to set up encryption on your folders, essentially password protecting files and folders on your Mac. So to be able to open up a file and folder, you'll actually need a password to get in. So let's firstly go have a look at how to set up a locked folder and then how to set up encryption and password protect your folders and your files. Here we are on our Mac. We've got documents. We've got a folder here called file to lock. This is what I actually want to look at locking. Now at the moment, I can go and remove things without too much problem. If I just grab this file and I can just delete it, and there it goes, it's deleted, right? And if I can add anything new, I can just grab and drag and things are in there quite well, all right? What I can do is I can right click, I can go into get info. I've now got an option to tick on locked. If I select that one, you'll notice that the icon has now changed with a lock next to it. And now on my finder, you can see that it's actually locked. So if I now go into here and try to delete a file, I'm gonna get a bit of a warning. So if I go and try and delete this, I'm gonna get asked for my password. Now, let's say if I throw my password in here, it's gonna say, sorry, cannot do this because you don't have permission to access some of these items. That file is locked because it's part of the folder that is currently locked. If I go and try to delete the folder itself, you'll notice that I get a warning over here that says, item file to lock is locked. Do you want to move it to the trash anyway? So it's almost like that second level of verification to make sure, do you actually want to delete this folder or not? If I say stop, it will not delete it. But then to easily remove this, go back into get info and then untick the locked area. I can then go in and start to delete a file without problem. That's locking a folder. However, that is not password protecting or encrypting it. This is where you now need to go into the disk utility to go and control that. So I'm going to go ahead and open up my disk utility. Here it is over here. You can access this by going into the applications area on your Mac, into utilities and open up disk utility, or you can also go to the spotlight and search for disk utility and open that one up. Once that is opened up, you're presented here with your hard drive and any other devices that are connected into your Mac. What I want to go and select is the file at the very, very top, and I'm going to say new image, image from folder or blank image. If I select blank image over here, it's gonna ask me now a name. Now I'm gonna go and create a folder or an archive that is password protected. So I'm gonna call this is password protected. There we go, .dmg. It's gonna save it into this spot. I can give this a name, I'm gonna call it the same thing. How big do you want this to be? Now this is essentially gonna create an archive, like a zipped file, right? And that is the full size that I'm allowed to use. So I'm gonna go and give this a relevant size. So maybe I want it to be a little bit bigger. I want it to be 1000 meg, so 1 gig big. What is the format that I want to use? I'm gonna recommend using the APFS format because that is the one that Apple uses as of this time. And it's the best one, I think, for this exercise. Then you've got the option for encryption. And this is where you're now going to encrypt the file. This is where you now set up a password protection. You can set up two different types, 128-bit or 256. Always go for the higher option. You're going to get better encryption and better scrambling of those files. Okay, so I'm going to set up the big one over here. So I'm now prompted to enter in a password and to verify. This is the password that is going to be needed to be able to decrypt that archive and open it up. So I'm going to throw in a password right here. Ready to go. Partition we can leave as is, and image format we can leave as is. But just be aware that there are other options available to you if you want to change the partition itself, and say save. That is now creating our disk image.
Once the operation is successful, we can now go back into our folder, and here is the file, right there. There it is, this passwordprotected.dmg. Now, if I double click on this one to open it up, it will ask me for the password, and this is where I throw in the password. Now, you'll notice that in my finder down the bottom left-hand corner, there is a new mounted archived file. Now in here, this is now currently empty, and this is now where I can dump in some files into there. So here are some files that I want to lock. So let's just go and select a couple of these and some icons, and I'm going to copy and paste these in, remembering that this is the size of the files and I've set it to be 1000 megs. So it's not going to allow me to put more than that. So I'm going to go and grab these and drag them in, or I can copy them. Let's just go ahead and copy and paste. So files have now been added in. Noticing down the bottom how much space I've got left. If I try to add anything bigger, let's just say I want to grab all of these, I'm getting the warning that there is not enough free space, okay? Now, that is done. I can now eject it. Now, this is my encrypted and password protected DMG file. I can no longer access this one unless I double click on it to open it up, and then it'll ask me for my password. Mounts it and throws it into there, and now I can access those files.
Hey, there you have it. We are done. Thank you so much for tuning in. As always, click on that subscription button, clicking on the bell. Give us a thumbs up if you found this video helpful, and let us know down below in the comments also what you thought. Thanks so much for tuning in, and we will see you on the next video.